This is a community-supported legal education channel. Find out how you can support our mission at the links in the description below.
So a Southern District of New York judge who previously ruled that embedding is perfectly legal and not copyright infringement is now reconsidering that. And I think this is a really scary thing. So let's see what's going on with Judge Kimba M. Wood's opinion and order in the Sinclair versus Ziff Davis and Mashable case. Plaintiff Stephanie Sinclair moves for reconsideration. So reconsideration is like an appeal, but you're appealing to the same judge. So you're not going up to an appeals court. You're saying, this judge, you made an error that you can correct. The court dismissed her second amended complaint against Ziff Davis and Mashable. Familiarity with the opinion is assumed. So let's put the bubble up there. We did cover this before. Plaintiff's motion for reconsideration is granted. Revising its previous holding, the court now holds that the pleadings do contain insufficient evidence to find that Instagram granted Mashable a sublicense to embed plaintiff's photograph on its website. So the complaint was dismissed, so we're not here on a judgment. This isn't a opinion and order on a judgment. It's not summary judgment. This is not the decision of the court saying that one party has won the case. Rather, this was a decision of the court saying that the plaintiff hadn't presented enough evidence to overcome the presumption that embedding grants a license. Let's see what the judge has to say. The court adheres to its prior holding in all respects. Therefore, defendant's motion to dismiss the second amended complaint is now granted in part and denied in part. The legal standard for a motion for reconsideration: the motion should be granted only when the movant identifies an intervening change of controlling law, or the availability of new evidence, or the need to correct a clear error, or to prevent a manifest injustice. This standard is strict, and reconsideration will generally be denied unless the moving party can point to controlling decisions or data that the court overlooked. It is well settled that Rule 59 is not a vehicle for relitigating old issues, presenting the case under new theories, securing a rehearing on the merits, or otherwise taking a second bite at the apple. The court adheres to its previous holding that by agreeing to Instagram's terms of use, plaintiff authorized Instagram to grant API users, which is application programming interface. It's the way that websites can talk to, or rather developers can have their software talk to websites, through software rather than having to go to a website, you know, move your mouse over, click here and everything. So if I want, I want to see the user profile for Leonard French, I can make a request by code. I can send a URL, a request, like a HTTP GET request for a specific URL, maybe with specific attributes or parameters attached to it. And then the web server will interpret that. And instead of displaying a web page, it will send data back to me. Or in this case, when you put an embed tag in your website for an Instagram post or a YouTube post or something like that, it sends an HTTP GET request for the embed tag and comes back with a snippet of code of HTML that goes onto your website and reproduces the post. But you're not actually reproducing the Instagram post. You're not going to the Instagram page and copying the text and picture of the post and pasting that into your HTML document. No, you're pasting code, and the code requests it from Instagram. Instagram receives the request, says, here's the answer to your request in the form of, here's the code you need to display it on your page. So Instagram is giving you the code to display it on your page. That's going to be important in this. Plaintiff's arguments to the contrary, which include that the court relied on the wrong version of Instagram's policies, that plaintiff never agreed to Instagram's terms of use, and that plaintiff's agreement with Instagram was unsupported by consideration, are without merit or are procedurally improper because they were not previously raised. So in other words, can't raise new stuff. The court does, however, revise the opinion by finding that the pleadings do contain insufficient evidence that Instagram exercised its right to grant a sublicense to Mashable. As evidence of its purported sublicense, Mashable presented Instagram's platform policy, which states that Instagram provides the APIs to help broadcasters and publishers discover content, get digital rights to media, and share media using web embeds. The court previously concluded that this term of the platform policy granted Mashable a sublicense to use the API to embed the photograph in its website. Yes, as any one of us internet and web users would think was perfectly normal. And as I'm assuming, almost every web developer assumed was perfectly legal. In reaching this conclusion, the court did not give full force to the requirement that a license must convey the licensor's explicit consent to use a copyrighted work. The platform's policy statement that the API is intended to help broadcasters publish and discover content, get digital rights to media, and share media using web embeds could be interpreted to grant API users the right to use the API to embed the public content of other Instagram users, but that is not the only interpretation to which the term is susceptible. Therefore, although courts may find a license on a motion to dismiss where the terms of the governing contracts are clear, the platform policy's terms are insufficiently clear to warrant dismissal of plaintiff's claims at this stage of litigation. The court holds that plaintiff's copyright claim against Mashable cannot be dismissed on the basis of Mashable's sublicense defense on the record currently present before the court. Finally, the court adheres to its prior holding that plaintiff failed to state a claim of copyright infringement against Ziff Davis. As the court explained in the opinion, pleading that Ziff Davis controls Mashable, the alleged infringer, is insufficient to state a claim of copyright infringement against Ziff Davis. Instead, plaintiff would have needed to plead substantial continuing involvement by Ziff Davis in Mashable's alleged infringement. She did not do so. For the foregoing reasons, plaintiff's motion for reconsideration is granted. Ziff Davis is removed from the case, but Mashable is not. The clerk of court is directed to reopen the case. So let me summarize. The court is not saying that you cannot embed Instagram posts, but the court is saying that in this lawsuit, this plaintiff alleged that there was copyright infringement, and Mashable did not present enough evidence to convince the court that there was an implied or express license. And the court said that we can't even recognize an implied license at this stage. We can only recognize an express license at the motion to dismiss stage. And we're not convinced that the expressed license was unequivocally expressed. There is another valid interpretation of the license clause. So maybe we need to have further test. Well, not maybe. We need to have more testimony and evidence and hearings and stuff. We need to go to some kind of discovery, maybe even a trial, and either the thing will be resolved on summary judgment or it'll be resolved after a trial with a judgment. So not the end of the world, but definitely something to be concerned about. I would have thought that an API call to embed a Instagram post on a third-party website without further authorization would be at least an implied license and most likely an express license to use the already licensed copyrighted material that's been licensed to Instagram by the original poster, the content poster, the user that generated the user-generated content, because they have a license agreement with Instagram giving Instagram the right to do that. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Before I do my normal credits, let me offer my special thanks to July supporter BU Number One Simmons. I understand that Navy Builder Simmons and his wife, both Iraq War veterans, are big fans of our channel and watch every day. We really appreciate the support and your kind words. For reasons that aren't entirely clear or public at this time, veterans have significantly higher risks for major illness. ALS, or amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, the terminal motor neuron disease you might know from Stephen Hawking and Lou Gehrig, is found at over twice the rate in veterans as civilians. The cause is yet unknown, there is no cure, and the decline is inevitable. 90% of cases present without a family history. Gulf War Syndrome is a chronic and multi-symptom disorder which affected over 250,000 soldiers returning from the 1991 Gulf War, as well as soldiers and sailors serving in and returning from the Middle East to this day. Illnesses include chronic fatigue syndrome, fibromyalgia, GI disorders, and a whole range of undiagnosed symptoms from headaches to joint pain to skin conditions. So, this July 4th, please take care to safely enjoy your celebration, and please find a moment to remember how much our veterans have given to ensure our freedoms are protected. Thanks for joining me. That's our show. I'm Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney, and this is Lawful Masses, your favorite legal news and education channel. We need your financial support on a monthly basis on patreon.com/LJFrench and sponsors.com/law. Thank you very much to the following $50 plus supporters in the month of June: Joe Tyson, Wes Delge, Citizen of the Sovereign, John Steele, Gavin Barnard, Evie, Kyle Mudrock, Spirit Bear, Jan Negre, Michael Pierce, Daniel Perez, Blackleaf, Benjamin Hightoff, Steven, Otta, Cute Grills in Your Area, Longreach Jones, Definitely Not Prenda Law, Ugly Grill, Shiloh T, Josh Baker, Gregory, Rudolph Bescherer Jr., Christian Hellman, Jay Dixon, Emma Knight, Oscar the Prophet, and Hot Grills in Your Area. And thank you to the $5 plus supporters that will be scrolling on the LED panel aside from me, the screen in front of me, and everybody will be in the description of the videos that drop. I love you all. I will see you in the videos. Have a great week. Bye.